Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
The president has made a point of communicating that Dr. Fauci has gotten a lot of things wrong, including the masks, which we've talked about, as well as asymptomatic spread. And I'm wondering if you could respond to the things that maybe the medical community got wrong early on.
I think at the very beginning, we didn't get the mask issue correctly. That was really universal throughout the United States, because we really thought we were looking at masks being protective for you, and what turns out to be that it's protective for everybody except you. When you cough, if you're infected, you have a mask, you don't spread it. We were thinking the other way around. But we learned our lesson, and now masks are recommended everywhere. As far as everything else wrong, I mean, we make mistakes all the time, but the thing is, when you make a mistake, you figure out why the mistake was made, and then you fix that mistake. And that's just the way doctors have always worked, public health people have always worked. And, as far as anything else coming out of our leaders in public health, they've been pretty much right on.
You know, we've been hearing from you and from a lot of people that the key to reeling this in is getting testing, but there's a big problem with the delay in the results of these tests.
It's terrible. The capacity is not there. You can't have the states all competing against each other for the reagents, for the central labs. It's all everybody going after the same thing. There it has to be a nationwide organization of the whole testing process. It doesn't work with just private industry or individual states or cities or individual hospitals even negotiating to get these test kits and tests available. That doesn't work. It has to be centralized, and it's not.
And yet, when you talk about sending kids back to school, which is a discussion in the news this morning, what's going on in Lake Forest might be different than what's going on in Florida. So what are your thoughts about sending kids back to school?
Well, but you said it, Larry. It depends where you are. It's a very different situation in suburban Chicago or some of the neighborhoods of Chicago compared to in Florida. Florida is a catastrophe. That state, there should be no school opening up in Florida. That's the same is true for Georgia and Texas and Arizona and maybe even parts of Southern California. So it depends what's happening in the region that you're in. You have to look at it that way.
All right, let's go to some viewer questions. This person says, I tested positive for COVID-19 and recovered and later tested positive for antibodies. Does this mean I will not need a vaccine if and when it becomes available?
Well, this is the $64 million or $64,000 question. If you have antibodies and they're good antibodies, what we call neutralizing antibodies, that's what the vaccines are trying to give you. This person got the antibodies from actually getting the virus. So theoretically, this person doesn't need a vaccine. Now, maybe the vaccine will give a different or even a better antibody than the one that person has developed on their own. We have to find out about that if it's important. There's still really no 100% documented cases of people getting this twice. There's been a few reports popping up here and there, but they haven't been investigated thoroughly enough. So right now, if you've had it once, you develop antibodies, you're not going to get it, at least in the near future.
All right, here's our next question. If someone tests positive and quarantines for 14 days from the day of testing, is it safe to be around them day 15 and on, for example, staying in the same cottage with them for several days?
If you follow the CDC guidelines are reasonable on this particular question. So it's a minimum I think it's 10 days. 3 days have to be without any symptoms of the 10 days. So 7 days after the first appearance of the symptoms plus 3 days with no fever.
All right. Next question. Is the percentage of positive cases for Chicago and the suburbs high enough that we might be seeing tightening of the rules while the rest of Illinois is okay?
Well, there's a couple questions here. So the way the state is divided into these COVID-type regions, That's one question. So one region, the Chicago region, Chicago, Cook County, and Lake County may be, you know, kind of one group that may be higher risk compared to some of the other states. So that's one thing. As far as the numbers going up, certainly the number of cases, Illinois is on the list of rising cases. You know, we have close to 1,000 cases a day now. For several days in a row, we were down in the 500-600 range. Something's going on. What are we going to do about that? Just keep ignore it? You know, if that stays up at that level, something has to be done.
All right. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can go to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Doctor, thanks for being with us again.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks, Doctor.
Have a good day.
You too.
Check of the weather, Mike.